Good morning, everyone. We are in Canton this morning. I'm hanging out with Canton's finest, the Canton Fire Department. We're at, we're kind of going through some of the drills that they would put their recruits through, and it actually simulates some of the things they deal with every single day when they go out. And that's where Bill comes in. Bill's kind of going to be the John Madden of everything. Good morning, Bill.
Good morning.
Good to see you, big guy.
Glad to be here.
All right, MVAs. You guys just don't put out fire. You handle motor vehicle accidents, correct?
Absolutely. On the highway nowadays, with cars being smaller and lighter,
right,
when they get in an accident, they crunch. And they're designed to come and be compact.
Yeah.
But our job then is to cut them apart.
All right. So that's what we're going
to
do.
So the first thing,
so we arrived at the scene. The first thing we need to do is break the window.
We're going to break the window.
Okay.
Jason here is going to break the window. It allows two things. We can see inside the compartment. We can help talk to the passengers that are inside there, let them know what we're going to do.
Okay.
And then the next thing we're going to do is we're going to make a purchase point. So that's allowing our
remain
tool.
Remain calm. We're going to get you out, folks. Okay.
Kenny's going to save you. It's your day.
All right. So now what's happening here, Bill? What are we
doing? We're going to break that. We're going to make what we call a purchase point. Kenny, go ahead and strike that for me. Hit it again, again, again. Now we're going to pry that a little bit. Strike it again, Kenny.
Strike.
One more time. Good. Now we've got what we call a purchase point. That's a spot where we can put a tool in there and start to pry this vehicle apart.
Okay.
Back in the 70s, these cars were a lot heavier. The metal was a lot stronger, but now they're a lot more lightweight.
Okay.
And therefore, when you're prying that, it's going to want to bend and twist. We need to get to the hinge of this car.
Okay, a little bit more stop.
We need to break that hinge and open that hinge so we can get the door open.
Okay. So now I'm getting in here. We're doing little.
And as you're doing that, Kenny, the person inside of there is uncomfortable. They're nervous. They're scared.
Okay.
Their life is in your hands right now, Kenny, and you're doing a fine job.
All right. Going through there. So
see,
we're just trying to make a little gap. Yep.
Okay. You'll see a hinge shortly there.
Go ahead and
perfect.
Push it in a little bit
further.
Pushing
further.
A little bit farther in there.
Okay. Here we go.
Now we have a lot of factors here, Kenny. We have to watch for hazards around the car. We have to make sure the car is stable. We have to make sure that the occupant inside the car knows exactly what we're doing at all times. Bingo, there goes the door.
Look at that.
Nice job, Kenny.
Very good. We got in there, and then you guys keep going.
All
ladies
right.
and gentlemen, we're hanging out with Canton's finest out here, and we're taking a look at some of the things the firefighters do every single day, and they're still working on that door. We use the jaws of life to get it open, okay, and they're going at it. When we come back, lots to show you guys. Kicking it with Kenny. Stay with us.